For peace train sounding louder. Ride on the peace train. Come on.
Everybody, it is so awesome to be with you today. Isn't this pyramid amazing? I've been working on it this entire week. There's a science to it, you know. You have to be careful the way you space each cup, and when you add another layer to it, you have to be super careful. You have to be calm, and you can't have shaky hands. Whew. You have to be at peace. Hey, peace! That's our life app this month. Well, actually, peace is way more than just being calm and quiet and still. Peace is proving you care more about each other than winning an argument. Isn't that the way you want other people to treat you? Making peace is a great way to build a bridge to someone else, instead of letting hurt and disagreement get in the way. It's a great way to treat others the way you want to be treated. We've got another super cool story coming up about someone who had to decide if she could make peace. You're gonna love it. But first, let's take a look at about what we've already learned about peace this month. God made peace with us. And we can make peace with others. But sometimes we need to know, when should you walk away from a fight? Last week, we talked about how the nation of Israel started with Abraham and his family. At this point, though, the family had grown into a mighty nation. In fact, our story today takes place during a time when the nation of Israel was ruled by kings, by the first king of Israel, King Saul. However, one day, a prophet named Samuel anointed David as the next king of Israel. I mean, it was not like he was going to become king that day. It just meant he would become king someday. Well, I'm sure how you could see how this might become a little problematic for David and the existing king, King Saul.
Oh, yeah. King David. You see, David was a pretty famous guy. Maybe you even remember the story of David when he was just a little kid taking down the giant Goliath. Now, when David was chosen to be the next king of Israel, he was just a young man watching over flocks of sheep. God promised that David would one day be king. But in the meantime, King Saul, still the ruler, still the king of Israel. Now, Saul was jealous because David won battles and was so popular with the people. So Saul kept trying to figure out how to capture or hurt David. As a result, David and his men spent most of their time living on the run. They had to move around a lot and hide from King Saul or King Saul's armies. It wasn't easy. But if David wanted to stay alive long enough to become king, he had to stay on the run. Now one day, David and his men went down to the desert of Paran. They traveled near the land of a wealthy man named Nabal. That's right, there's another villain in this story. Now, Nabal was very rude and mean, but he had a very wise and intelligent wife named Abigail. Well, let's watch and see how Abigail becomes our superhero in this story.
Brendan. Brendan!
Yeah?
If I'm reading this correctly, it says we need to move the first one 2 feet.
What's that?
A little to the left. 2 feet.
You sure?
Says right here in the plans.
Sure thing, boss.
You sure you're reading that right?
I mean, it might be upside down.
What are those?
Blueprints. Hello, everybody. I'm Lawson.
And I'm Brandon, and welcome to the So-and-So Show.
Yes. And
on today's show...
Wait, are you...
Why are you talking over me?
No. We discussed this over our pre-show cornflakes.
We discuss no such thing.
Oh, of course. See, you never listen to me. You hear me.
That is
but
not
you
true.
Don't listen,
I do
Brandon.
Listen.
Oh, do you? How would you ever know to listen when you're too busy being on your phone the entire time?
I was looking at the intro to the show, which apparently you won't let me do.
Okay. Was the intro to the show a video of a ferret doing the conga line on loop?
It helps me focus.
You're teaming up funk?
Yes.
Feel like you aren't able to communicate?
Yes.
Then today's your lucky day. Hi, I'm Tanya, team motivator and influencer. Sometimes it can feel like your team is all over the place. Here, 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 here. But with my proven team building exercises, I can take your team from here to here before it gets to here. So call Teams by Tanya today.
Today. So it's just me and Brandon, and we are having trouble being a team.
He's having trouble being a team.
What do you mean I'm having trouble? There's no me in team, Brandon.
Yes, there is. There's an M and an E. There's a me in team. There's no I in team. That's the saying.
Gentlemen, it seems we're having trouble communicating.
Yes.
Brandon? Turn towards Lawson. Lawson, turn towards Brandon. Now close your eyes. Without making a sound, I want you to mouth these words. I can't see you, I can't hear you. Good. Keep going, mouthing those words. I can't see you, I can't hear you. Good, even bigger, but still without making any sound. Good, good, yes! Bigger, bigger. Good, I can't see you, I can't hear you. Now stop. Open your eyes. Look at each other. Good. Now close your eyes again. Okay. I want you to slowly open your eyes. Very small. Barely open your eyes. Whisper these words, Brandon, to Lawson. I see you and I hear you.
I see you and I hear you.
Even quieter.
I see you and I hear you.
Good. Lawson?
I see you and I hear you.
Good. Keep repeating that. And each time, I want you to open your eyes a little bit wider and get a little bit louder.
I see you and I hear you.
I see you and I hear you.
Good. Keep building that.
I see you and I hear you.
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 Louder! Tell them!
I see you and I hear you.
I see you and I hear you.
Yes, louder!
I see you and I hear you.
I see you and I hear you.
I see you.
here is done. Now it's Bible story time with Kellen.
Hey, gents.
Kellen.
Yes?
I see you and I hear you.
Okay. Thanks. Back at you.
Do you have a Bible story for us today?
Absolutely. And here to help me tell it are the So-and-So Show Players!
Yeah.
Today's story comes from the book of 1 Samuel, chapter 25. There was a man named Nabal. Nabal was known to be rude and mean, and he was married to Abigail, who was wise and clever. But we'll get to her in a minute. Now, Nabal was very wealthy. He had 1,000 goats and 3,000 sheep. And it was time for Nabal to shear his sheep and sell the wool. There's another character in today's story. His name is David. You might remember David as the shepherd boy who slayed a giant and then became king. This is that same David. But in our story, he hasn't become king yet. David was staying with his men in the desert when he heard that Nabal was shearing his sheep.
Frances!
Oh. Yes, David.
I want you to go to Nabal, and I want you to greet him kindly for me. And then I want you to remind him of how well we treated his men when they were with us. And lastly, I want you to ask him. Ask him if there's anything he can share with me and the other men. Go!
Yes! Yes, sir!
David's men delivered the message to Nabal, but Nabal's response was, well...
So, David would just like you to remember all that he did for you, and then, you know, would appreciate if you could find anything for us.
I'm sorry. Who? David who? Son of Jesse who? Why should I give up my bread and my meat that I have prepared? Why?
Because...
Why? The answer is not just no. It is no. Million times no. Be gone with you.
Go.
No.
Go.
Million times no.
Million times
no.
Million times no.
David's men reported back everything Nabal had said to them.
No. No. A million times no.
Watch. Watch. Men, put on your swords because we are going to destroy Nabal.
David was angry.
I don't have my sword.
Maybe a little too angry. Now, Nabal was in big trouble unless somebody could stop David. That's where Nabal's wife, Abigail, comes in.
Abigail!
Yes, Frankie?
Nabal just insulted David. David, the guy who's been keeping us safe while we watch our sheep. David's really mad, and I think he's out for revenge, so... You gotta do something.
All right, people. Listen up. We're gonna have to do this fast. I need you to go get 200 loaves of bread, Frankie. Billy? Grab 2 bottles of wine, and I'm not talking the small ones, I'm talking the big ones and the animal skins.
Sure thing, boss.
Sally.
Yes, Abigail?
I need you to get the 5 sheep ready to be cooked.
You got it.
And Frankie! I'm gonna need a bushel of grain.
Okay.
And 100 raisin cakes.
Okay.
And 200 cakes of pressed figs. Let's go, people! There's no time to waste!
Abigail wasted no time. After she collected all the food, she loaded it onto the donkeys and met David, who was approaching from the desert.
Ah! Can you believe it, men? How he has treated us? We have served him, and how did he repay us? He repaid us with evil.
and we will destroy Nabal! Yeah!
Pardon me, sir.
Yes?
I must speak with you. Let me take the blame. Pay no attention to that man, Nabal.
Nabal!
Yeah! He's really not worth getting that worked up over.
Who?
Nabal.
No!
No. Eyes, right here. His name means...
What?
His name means fool. Yes. He does many foolish things.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, Nabal.
So you don't need to kill Nabal, do you?
Yeah!
No!
No?
No.
No. No.
No. You see, God has prevented you from killing Nabal and his men. And I have brought many gifts for you to have.
Ah, men. So you have. It's very kind.
So you don't need to kill Nabal. God will take care of it. He's going to appoint you king over all of Israel, and you don't want to have to worry about how you killed Nabal and didn't have to, right?
Yeah, you make a lot of sense.
Thank you. I just ask that when you're king, you remember me.
All right. All right, go, go. You may go in peace. I have heard what you have come here to say, and I will do as you have asked. Goodbye!
So Abigail returned home, and David stayed put. With her quick thinking, Abigail was able to make peace. The end.
Great story, Kellen. Thanks.
And many thanks to the So-and-So Show players.
Okay, okay. That wasn't terrible.
Yeah, Abigail was incredible.
To be able to soften a situation like that took a lot of courage from Abigail.
Yeah, David was so angry he could kill. But God used Abigail. After talking to her, David walked away from a fight and didn't make a huge mistake he probably would have regretted.
Making peace isn't easy, is it?
Not at all. Sometimes people think the person trying to make peace is weak because it looks like they don't want to fight or argue. But being a peacemaker is incredibly hard, and it usually takes a lot of work.
And a lot of raisin cakes.
Oh, you know it.
Great story. Thanks, Kellen.
Yep, I'll see you guys next time.
Later.
Wish I could be a peacemaker like Abigail or Tanya. But how, Brandon? How?
I don't know. But let's find out. Reveal the question! What are ways you can be a peacemaker? Maybe you can be a peacemaker with two of your friends.
Or within your family, or maybe a sports team.
Or maybe you can be a peacemaker by saying you're sorry. Lawson, I'm sorry that I get angry at you sometimes. You're a great friend.
Thanks, buddy. I'm sorry, too. I don't think either of us were peacemakers today.
Yeah. Until now, high five!
Yeah!
That was close enough.
All right,
that was close enough.
Yeah.
There are lots of ways you can be a peacemaker. Talk about it with each other. And we'll see you next time on
The So-and-So Show.
I can't see you.
Good. Oh. I can't hear you.
I can't see you.
What did you say, Brandon?
I can't see you.
Tanya.
I can't see.
Are my hands still over my ears?
I can't see you.
Why are my eyes closed?
I can't see you.
I can't hear you. I can't see you.
I need a nap.
Good.
I need water.
This
I need a nap.
Building.
I can't see the point.
Why?
Good work, Tanya.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do that.
Way to go. Abigail, she was truly a wonder woman. We see through her example that God can work through each of us to make peace between others. Abigail did something really difficult. She came between two parties who were divided and found a way to make peace. She became the bridge that brought people together who were separated. And that is no small thing. Have you ever caught on to some tension flaring up between a couple of your friends? And in that moment, you have all sorts of choices you can make. You can say things to splash gasoline on what is sparking, like, oh yeah, they always act like that. Or, but did you hear when they said this? Soon enough, those sparks are a full-blown fire. Or, you could be the water that helps put out the sparks. Like, are you sure that's what they said? Or, what if we talk about this together? But maybe it has nothing to do with your friends, like in Abigail's story. Maybe you have someone in your life who genuinely is not a nice person to you or your friends or your siblings. You may need to start thinking about a safe way that you can help to build a bridge to build peace. You can show you care about others by being part of the solution.
You know, it might seem easier to just stay out of somebody else's problem. But you never know how God might use you to be a part of the solution. God gave you a heart that cares about people and a creative mind so that you can find all sorts of ways to help. You know, if a couple of your friends are arguing, maybe you could calm the situation down by helping them talk about it. Maybe you hear some kids talk badly about someone else. You could defend that person and talk about how much you like them and value their friendship. Remember, if you're not sure what to do, you can always talk to a trusted adult. They can help you think of all different ways that you can step in and make things right. And for another way of seeing how you can be a peacemaker, well, watch this one thing.
Hey everybody, I'm Lawson, and today we're talking about peace. Piece of cake? It smells so good. And does anybody have a fork?
Peace, Lawson, not peace.
Yeah, oh, I know. P-E-A-C-E on Earth and all that. I just wanted an excuse to eat cake. Anyhow, at least there are cookies in today's story about P-E-A-C-E peace, as told to me by my young friend Raj. Now Raj lives like five houses down from the school. So every morning at 7:35, he heads out the front door and down the sidewalk. And every morning at 7:36, Mr. Samson beelines down the driveway with his coffee to get his newspaper. Because I guess some people still actually get newspapers. He claims, it's the smell of the ink. And at precisely 7:37, Jade Zimmerman runs through with her pesky dog, Thunderbolt. Now Raj usually gets stuck right between them. Then Mr. Samson complains, that dog of yours pees on my mailbox. And Jade snaps, that mailbox is an eyesore. Because Mr. Samson's mailbox needs a little bit of work. And it's still decorated for Christmas. So, Raj takes some extreme measures. He yells, stop! But Mr. Samson shouts at Jade, your dog is killing my flowers! And she yells back, I'm voting you out of the neighborhood! Raj finally makes a break for it. But their words come flying after him. And it happens like that again. And again. Raj tells his mom, they're driving me nuts. And she says, maybe you can help. So, Raj makes a plan. And the next morning, he's ready with treaty treats. They've got chocolate chips for Mr. Samson with healthy oatmeal for Jade.
And while his neighbors are busy chewing, Raj offers to help Mr. Samsung take down the Christmas decorations and plant some daffodils around it. And Raj offers Jade a bag of dog treats so she can coax Thunderbolt to do his business somewhere else. And then they all high 30! And at last, there's a little piece for Raj's morning trek to school. So kids, never leave your Christmas decorations up past Valentine's Day. But always do remember that peace is proving you care more about each other than winning the argument. Hey! Aha! Ooh! Time for a little peace? Okay.
It's so good. I'll see you guys next time. I love you so much.
You see, just like Abigail, Raj wasn't the one who caused the problem. He wasn't involved in the fight, but he got involved so that he could make peace. He chose to be a part of the solution. And that's our bottom line. You can show that you care about others by being part of the solution. Now let's take a moment to talk to God and ask God to help us be peacemakers with our friends, our family members, and anyone else who we might have a conflict with. Will you pray with me? Dear God, we thank you for the story of Abigail and for the reminder that we can be a part of the solution. You can use us to make peace even if we're not the ones who have an argument to begin with. God, help us look for ways that we can make peace and show the people in our lives that we care about them. We love you, God, and pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, let's finish up our time here at Grace Place the way we always do by saying together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Have a great week. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Oh, peace train sounded louder. Not on the peace train.